Ah, welcome, weary traveler. You look like a traveler in need of relaxation and the finest of chemical assistance. Well, wander no more, my good friend, for I am Doc Hoff, procurer of the finest of medical goods and chemical assistance. Now, how may I help you? I provide food, drinks, and discreet chemicals to discerning customers around the wasteland. I help ease the suffering of my fellow man. For a prize. I don't have a home office exactly, but I organize much of my trade with Ernest Rowe in Canterbury Commons. Let's see what the good doctor has in his magic bag, shall we? Another satisfied customer for a price. That.
Yes?
Here. Fight company!
Amongst us, who would shatter our hopes for peace, order, and security. These radical malcontents don't care about you. They don't care about America. All they care about is fulfilling their own selfish desires. Let's take a tally of these agitators, shall we? There are, of course, the raiders, those anarchistic ruffians who roam the preying upon any and all steel. The so-called Brotherhood of Steel, though being fooled by their pseudo-knightly nonsense or supposed connections to the United States Army, these power-armed and Boy Scouts are nothing more than common criminals with access to some antiquated technology. Criminals who have had the audacity to claim this country's most important military installation at the Pentagon as their own personal clubhouse. And don't be fooled, America. Those who have left the Brotherhood of Steel, branded outcasts, are just as dangerous, even more so, being in exile. And what about the slaves of Paradise Falls? The frighteningly irradiated ghouls of Underworld. And last but not least, the hideously mutated super mutants that have completely overrun the entire downtown DC.
We got away from the slavers who were taking us to Paradise Falls, but they said our colors were explosive. Blow our heads off if we ran. Do you think you can get this thing off of me before it's too late? Well, to hell with it. Go ahead and try. Good luck. Hey, I think it worked. We got away from the slavers who were... Do you think you can get this... Well... Is it supposed to vibrate like that?
Welcome to Vault 112, resident. According to sensors, you have arrived 202.3 years behind schedule. Please redress in your Vault Tech issued Vault suit before proceeding. If you have misplaced your suit, I am authorized to distribute a new one. Once dressed, please proceed down the stairs to the main floor so that you may enter your assigned Tranquility Lounger. Please take a seat in the nearest available Tranquility Lounger. Thank you for your cooperation. Tranquility Lounger is available.
Hey there, sport. Beautiful day, isn't it? Say, you should go talk to Betty. She's waiting for you over on the playground. Have fun, sport.
Play? What? You're weird. It's okay, I guess. I don't really have nobody to play with, except for Betty, and she's kind of... Well, she's mean. Your dad? Nope, I haven't. Did he get lost? Have a great day.
Hello. Hiya, kiddo. What's the good word? Nice place. Real nice. Everyone's friendly and always happy to lend a hand.
Hi there. Oh, someone new to play with. What good luck I have lately. I was just starting to get bored. Oh, we're going to have so much fun. What's he like? That's your daddy? Oh, we're going to have so much fun. This is going to be the best game ever. I knew you would. It's a really simple game. All you have to do is make Timmy Newsbomb cry. He's the only other kid that lives here besides you. He's a big crybaby. You'll see. Make him cry, and then come back here so we can talk some more.
Hello.
Hi, wanna play? What? Did I do something bad? I won't wet the bed again. I promise. I promise. No, no.
Yay, I knew you could do it.
Perhaps not the most inventive approach, but persuasion can be quite powerful. Well done. And for winning the game, you get a prize. You get to ask one question and receive an honest answer. I was known as Dr. Stanislaus Braun, but here I choose this identity. Do you find it unsettling? In this place, I can choose to be whatever I wish, and this is what I have chosen.
You will find that I control a great deal around here. But I am helping you.
I am answering questions. More than the one original question I granted you, I might add. And now I think it is time you do something for me. Pay a visit to the Rockwells. They're very happily married. And I'd like you to change that. Put an end to their marriage, and we'll talk. Rationalize it any way you'd like. If you succeed, we'll continue our discussion.
Some impressive things they're doing these days.
That the commies in China wish they had it as good as we do, eh?
I'm certainly grateful for everything we have. Hello! Hiya, kiddo. What's the good word? Now, what's a kid like you want to know about that? Kind of grown-up stuff to be worried about, don't you think? Well, don't you worry your head about it. They worked out their problems a while ago. Haven't heard them fight in a long time. Is that so? Well, you ought to tell that to my big toe, kiddo. Hurts like the dickens since I stubbed it earlier today. Feels pretty real to me. Good day.
You don't belong here. You're not supposed to be here. It's not real, none of it. It needs to end. The suffering must end. You're the only one who can end it. You must end it, don't you see? You're the only one who can disable the failsafe. You need to know the truth. Otherwise, he'll suck you in just like all the others. Beware!
Good day.
Good day. Hello, sweetie. How are you?
It's that Martha Simpson, isn't it? I knew it! That's it! I've had enough of Roger's lies and bullshit!
How did it come to this? I just don't understand.
Poor Janet and Roger.
So, you have achieved your goal. I was hoping for something a bit more dramatic, but persuasion appears to be your strong suit. And at least you are cooperative, unlike your father. I was most disappointed when he refused to participate, yet still expected something from me. I am pleased to see I'm not the only one being entertained. You're far more agreeable than your father. If you wish for more, then so be it. But let's raise the stakes a bit this time. I'd like you to kill Mabel Henderson. But do be creative about it. Beating her to death just won't suffice. Put some effort into it.
Music to my ears.
Hello.
No! Nagel. Always good for a laugh. Well done. Well done. You certainly do get results. You have exceeded my expectations.
And now, we come to the last task I have for you. Succeed, and you shall be granted whatever you wish. I think you'll find that I have been quite honest with you thus far. You have no discernible reason to mistrust me. In the doghouse, out behind the abandoned home, are a mask and knife. Don the mask and become the pint-sized slasher. Use the knife to eliminate all the residents of Tranquility Lane. I thought you might find it amusing. It draws upon an old urban legend, a story told over campfires many years ago. The residents have all heard the story and will fear you. Go forth and make me proud!
Good day.
Pint-sized slasher! Thank you.
here after all.
Things to do.
Most enjoyable. Most enjoyable indeed. I haven't felt this exhilarated in years.
I had the distinct impression you enjoyed yourself. We are like you and I. Now, you ask for the means to leave Tranquility Lane, and so I grant it to you. The door is open.
You are... Of course, welcome to stay a bit longer if you like.
You've saved me. I was afraid I'd be trapped in there forever. Oh, it's so good to see you, but... What are you doing here? Well, I'm glad you did. This certainly wasn't how I expected things to turn out. I wasn't ready for Braun, or I might have fared better. It certainly is. It's nice to feel that I'm on two legs again. And thanks to Dr. Braun, I know that Project Purity isn't lost after all. No. It would be time to rest when the work is complete. This is far too important. I need to get back to Rivet City right away. There's so much to be done. You must understand. As much as I love you, this project has been my responsibility since long before you were even born. Too many people have made sacrifices to give up on it now. Your mother, if you'll let me, I'd like to show you what we've accomplished. I want you to be there when we change the world. After so many years, I can finally see it through to the end. I can't stop now. Really? You're not going to join me? Coming all this way after me, I'd have thought you'd want to help. I have to keep going. I can't stop now. I'm going back to Rivet City. Meet me there if you change your mind. It would be good to work with you, honey. I understand that you have reason to question a good many things I've told you over the years. But your mother... I've never lied to you about what happened. Not once. She died giving birth to you. It was a difficult time. She was so eager to meet you, to make a place for you in the world. If nothing else, please believe that she loved you very much. It started as an idea, really. Remember the Bible passage your mother loves so much? Free, clean water for everyone. What a difference it could make in the lives of everyone here in the Wastes. Over time, that idea took the form of a purifier. Not like the one in the vault, though. This one was gigantic, capable of purifying millions of gallons of water at once. We used the old Jefferson Memorial for the location, right on DC's tidal basin. Someday soon, I hope you'll see it work. In the year before you were born, things became difficult. There had always been something of a mutant problem in the city, but it became worse. They attacked more frequently and more aggressively. Support for the project eroded as time went on, when we couldn't produce any significant results. Progress came to a halt. And then you were born. Your mother and I had talked about what to do when that time came, but then we lost her, and I had to make a decision. I chose to leave. From what I understand, things happened quickly after that. It became too dangerous for the others to stay, and so the project was abandoned. Dr. Lee and her team left for what became Rivet City, and Project Purity has sat waiting ever since. The vault you grew up in had its own water purification system. Clean water was never a worry. Out here, things are different. Water out here is never clean, and almost always irradiated. It's barely able to sustain any kind of normal life. If we can change that, humanity has a real chance at rebuilding, starting over. Be careful, sweetie.
Hello, ma'am.
Good to see you again, sweetie. That's good to hear. Let's not waste any time.
Forget you. Thank you for your help. I